We're welcoming another artist. She's beautiful and young, but her song is like if she's looking at a crystal ball, imagining how love and life will be in the future. It's Ieva Zasimauskaitė from Lithuania. Yeah, you can clap. We have 5 minutes for the photo opportunity if you want to come to this side of the stage. Here she is, Ieva Zasimauskaitė. Yeah, please, take a seat. Okay, can you all take a seat, please? We're starting the meet and greet. Thank you for coming. It's such
a
pleasure to have you.
Thank you for having me here.
But I have to say that you're making everyone in Lisbon cry. It's true.
It's good.
Is it a good thing?
Yeah, it's very good when you're crying about nice things because it seems that your heart is cleaning, so it's very nice. Yeah.
So you think that's actually the goal in your song is to make people like clean themselves, bring up their emotions, look at you.
The most important thing is to feel the message of my song that we need to be together till the end of our lives, not to be alone, but like two or three or four, it doesn't matter, but not to be alone whole life.
That's beautiful. And are you happy? Were you happy with your first rehearsal? Do you feel at home?
It seems, yeah, that I'm very happy. I'm very excited. The stage are perfect for my song. I really liked it. People who are working here are very nice and sweet. So
yeah,
I feel
good.
Like at home. Yeah, really. I feel like in home. I'm very happy.
Great. So who had this idea of having your husband on stage? Because you did that in the Lithuanian national final.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you decided to repeat it here.
I think it was my very nice friend, my best friend, Rasa Mitsahiene idea. She's sitting right there. So, yeah, that was her idea, and I'm very happy with that because we were thinking a lot with Marius if it will be nice or if it will be not so nice. But yeah, I think I won because of him.
Yeah.
So we will try again.
We'll try again. But when he comes on stage and you see him there, how do you feel? What does it feel? Does it feel like, okay, this is a warming feeling and now this song suddenly makes sense and you can transmit that to the public?
Yeah,
is that
I
also
always
one of the
feel
reasons?
Tears in my eyes.
Really?
Yeah, and I'm always like, oh my God, don't cry, not now. Yeah, but like, one time I'm doing this, second time I'm doing this, and like every time I feel tears in my eyes because you know, the most important thing in life that I have him because it's like a miracle.
Yeah.
He is so patient. You would see him. Yeah, but you would see him when I'm not happy and not so nice, you know, when I'm angry at home and I'm fighting with him.
Okay.
He's still there, like every time he's there, so I'm very, very happy that he is now. Mm-hmm.
And was it hard to convince him to do this on stage, or is he okay and at ease with it?
He said that he will. He's doing this for me. He don't want to be on stage because you know he's a man. but he said that yeah, he's doing this for me, so it's okay for him.
For him, it's fine.
Yeah.
So you, of course, you didn't write the song yourself.
No.
But you're young, first of all, of course, and you're like a very funny girl, actually.
Thank you.
But
it's a compliment, or
no, it's a compliment. Like, you're very smiley, but you are talking about something that usually people tend to think that it's quite serious,
yeah.
Which is this aging process.
Yeah.
So the first time that you listened to this song, did you feel that immediately that it would be something that you would want to sing?
Yeah, of course. I didn't plan to go to Eurovision this year because I was going to Eurovision for 4 times and I was thinking that, okay, I need to make a break. But when I heard this song from the first time, oh, my heart was melting, you know, because the words, it seems that I wrote the song from the very beginning till the very end because I can feel it, like, I can feel everything, you know,
like
in that song.
The song,
yeah,
when you, when
because
it's...
from 16 years old or from 15, I wanted to have a family. And I think much younger I wanted to have a family, but everybody was laughing from me. So yeah, these things are very near to me.
So you were saying that, did you want to be in Eurovision? Did you,
yeah,
think about that for a long time? Because you went into the Lithuanian pre-selection,
yeah,
quite a few times.
Yeah.
And you also have like a special connection with Eurovision because you sang with a previous Eurovision winner. With Dima Bilan from Russia. How,
yeah,
was that? How did that opportunity come up? And what did you sing, actually?
Yeah, I was in The Voice of Lithuania.
Okay.
In a project, and I was in super finals. So somebody invited Dima Bilan to that show. And I don't know why I get this opportunity to sing with him. But I was so lucky. Yeah. And the thing that I remember is his microphone, actually. Because it was very expensive. It's about 100,000 euros or something like that.
Just for his microphone.
Yeah, and I was like, oh no, why I should sing with this simple one? Yeah, and I remember that I thought that he's very arrogant and, you know, like Russian guy and like that, but he's very sweet, he's very gentle, and he's really kind person, so I was very happy. And we were singing that song, Never Never Let You Go.
Yeah, his first
this
song
one.
from
yeah.
Eurovision.
So
yeah. But it's good that you're bringing this simplicity to Lisbon. Thank you. Thank you for that. So we have the head of delegation from Lithuania,
yeah,
and we're opening to your questions. If there's anyone from the Lithuanian press, we would start with you. If not, we just open it to anyone that wants to. From there, maybe.
Hello, Eva.
Hi, my friend.
Nice to see you again. It's JP from Radio International.
Hello.
You went to the Junior Eurovision Song Contest some,
yes,
years ago. You became second in The Voice of Lithuania.
Yeah.
What experience do you bring with you from these events to Eurovision here?
Yeah.
What can help you?
The most important thing is to be yourself in whatever situation you have, not to act something that you don't feel, because I think that the most important thing for artists and for, I don't know, for all people, if you want that other person feel yourself, so you should be yourself first. So these two projects, it was like that, you know, so the main thing is this. Okay, thank you.
Okay, next question. Here in the front, thank you. Our volunteers have to keep on running.
Hello, Eva. I'm Advent Italian from EurovisionBulgaria.com.
Yeah.
So we've been hearing that your song When We're Old is inspired by a real life story. Could you tell us more about that?
Yeah.
Thank you.
I was in the arena in Žalgirio Arena. It was one concert where our ex-president with his wife was sitting, and they are really old persons, and they were holding their hands. Thank you. They were holding their hands, and they're really old people, you know. And these things I saw in cinema, in all romantic movies, because I'm into Notebook, Walk to Remember, and those kind of movies. And that thing I saw in real life. And then I thought that, oh my God, this would be my dream. I want this feeling with my husband, you know. When I will be old and when I will be like them, I want to be like that, you know, holding my hands and be like loving each other, not fighting and saying like, oh my God, why I'm with you. So this thing, yeah, it inspired me the most. Thank you,
okay,
for the question.
Some romantic inspiration coming from here. Yeah, there. Yes, hello, I'm Simon.
Hi,
from Polish Radio Newsletter. Welcome on board.
Thank you.
You know what? I met you already on the plane to Amsterdam.
Yeah, I remember you.
It's like a big family here.
such a great impression of joy and happiness, and I'm grateful for that.
Thank you so much.
So we're looking for dark horses. I wish you, Lithuania, victory for the first time. But my question is, because you know, you look so young, and you are so experienced. You said you already tried 3 times for the Eurovision Song Contest.
Yeah.
You were in the Voice of Lithuania, but you won also every selection program this year. It put any pressure, really, and interest of Lithuanian public opinion?
Mm.
That's my first part of the question. The second is about the experience from the programs you gave, the projects you gave here on this big stage. It helps or not?
Okay. So what was the first part?
Okay.
I'm sorry. I was very happy and very inspired of that because everybody's thinking that I'm not shy. I'm talking so much and like smiling so much, but actually, I'm very shy. And I think because of the shyness, I'm like, oh, like that.
It's like a reaction.
So, yeah. So, I was not planning to win, you know. Yeah, I was planning to do my best and to make it till the very end of the show. And I don't know, but yeah, people were writing messages, like thousands of messages from Lithuania. And I was like, oh my God, they really liked me. Because my husband is always saying that you are special, you're magical. And I'm saying, okay, you're my husband, you know, you're lying. So, and when people like started to write those messages, and I was like, oh my God, really, it's happening, you know, they like me, they like me. And I was very happy because actually people more liked my message of the song, and I was thinking that this is the main thing that I wanted to do in my life and my singing career, that every song should have a message that I can, like, that I can sing through my songs. It's okay for the first part? And the second part, so yeah, so I still have stage fear, so before going to stage always, but I found out that there's very good thing meditation and prayers before going to stage, so yeah, the more you're going, I don't know if the fear is going less, you know, for me no. Every time I'm going, I feel the same, you know, feeling. I feel the same, like, nervous thing. But I'm praying, and this helps me a lot. So, thank
Just
you.
A question regarding being a black horse for the head of delegation. So last year, Portugal won with a very silent song. And this year, you also have a very quiet, romantic song. So do you think Lithuania can extend this trend and win it? And are you ready and willing to win it, finally, for this moment?
You know, we are ready to win and make Eurovision for many, many years.
Okay.
So if this will happen this or next year or in 2 years, we will be happy to welcome everyone in Vilnius.
Bonus.
Okay, we'll talk about this later. Yeah, but it's from
the discussion already started.
Yeah, so this will be another big discussion. We're but let's first solve the question when, and then we will say where. Okay.
Good attitude. Okay, another question. Oh, there's a lot of questions here in the front.
Oh, sorry, I won't stand up because I'm recording. It's Stefan from ES United. I would
Hello.
Like to ask you about the animations you have, about the people inside. Do you have any family ties with them?
Family ties.
Thank you for the question, by the way.
So a lot of people are working with me. So if we are talking about blood relationships, so it's my husband. But, you know, during this preparation and rehearsals and everything, so this all team, they become my family. Okay, about the screen. I thought about the team I'm working with. Okay, I'm sorry. Yeah, about the people who are on the screen, so yeah, there's my parents, my mom and my daddy, and others, no, they're not my relationship, not my relatives. Yeah.
Okay, but you really make this place.
Yeah, but there's another couple, very famous in Lithuania, very famous ball dancers, Jūratė and Česlovas Norvaišos, they're very known in Lithuania also.
So you're making this place feel like home. Really,
yeah.
For real. Oh, careful. We already have one in the hospital.
My dad is a dentist.
Another one. Okay, there. Stay safe, team. We need you.
Okay.
Tautodas Euradena, Lithuania.
Hello.
Labas. So, last lines of the song were sung in Lithuanian today. So is this your final decision, and what was the reason that you came up with it? Because you seemed uncertain for a while about that.
These are the reasons. because I love my country. And I heard that before Eurovision was, if you are going like in Lithuania, you are singing in Lithuania. If you're going to like Bulgaria, you are singing in Bulgaria. So I chose these four lines because I think that our language is so beautiful, and I think that this song you can feel with your heart. You don't need to understand like words, and many people, not from Lithuania, but many people from foreign countries, they just asked me. That's why I decided, like, my final decision was because of those people, because they said like, please, 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 sing in Lithuania, please, please, please. So we did this because of all people. And we have 100 years in Lithuania, like big celebration. So like a present, so we will do this in Lithuania. Okay?
Okay, one last question here.
In the last line, he's from probably the first one.
Okay. So both of them now have to ask. So can we start here in the front and then we go to the back?
Hi, Eva.
Hello.
Michael from Eurovision, right? We've
Hello.
Been in contact before.
Hi.
This is my daughter, Lauren.
It's so nice that she has my flag.
Indeed. So this is a difficult question. This girl will tell you for the last 3 years, her and her sister have been listening to your records, Life Not That Beautiful, You Saved Me, and now your latest one. What are they going to do if you're not in the Lithuanian Eurovision thing next year? How are we going to get some more new music from you? Because we need to have some more songs to keep going.
Yeah.
So what's your plan, say, now? Because I'm assuming you won't go into the Eurovision thing next year.
Yeah.
And how has your life changed since you've actually won this year?
Mm-hmm.
Has things gotten better?
thank you for your question. It's so nice that you're listening to my songs. I'm very happy. And I'm really inspired by that. So yeah, we are making my first album with Vytautas Bikus. Yeah, so I just recorded my new song before going to Lisbon. So after Eurovision, immediately, I think first week, we will release my new song. And I will have 10 songs till August, I hope so. So you will get it first. And I don't know about Eurovision, I'm not planning anything now, but if others let me, so maybe, we will see, yeah.
Experienced singers are welcome.
One very quick question from the back there.
Yeah.
We ran out of time.
Hi, Alistair Birch from Eurofile.
Hello.
I understand you became a vegetarian a few years back. How has that impacted your life?
Okay, very nice question, thank you for that. 4.5 years I'm vegetarian, I'm not eating meat, fish and eggs, so I'm really happy about it because my voice is getting better because I don't have reflux anymore because I had it before, so my personality is getting better. I don't have a lot of things, a lot of fears that I had before because this was the reason. These are the reasons, again. So it was the reason why I wanted to change a little bit my diet. So, and I'm very happy because just before this press conference, my friend from Portugal bring me some really nice vegetarian food. So that's why I'm so happy and so active. So thank you for your question.
Thank you so much, Lithuania. Thank you, Eva, for being here. We talked about life and love and diet and everything. So this was a great press conference. Applause is from
Thank you so much.
Eva's awesome.